Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Finished all of that. Well, we did that one yesterday. I finished the other field through there. We're going to carry on down to, which one is it? Number 18 is our next field to cut. And then we'll go back over the road and we'll go down and do number 9 and then we'll work our way up through. So, the question that I'm asking this week is, because we're doing a whole load of grass, we're going to need some feeding technology soon. So do you want me to get the self-propelled Kuhn SPW25, which is 25,000 litres, but because it's self-propelled and can load itself with silage, it's obviously a bit pricey. This one is 64,000 litres, so it's considerably bigger, but it's trailed, so you've got to spoon in the silage yourself along with the hay and the straw. So do you want the Peecon 64 or the Kuhn 25? It's your vote, it's your game. Head down below, let me know which one you want. Before I go rushing off, you'll see that I now have 300 sheep and 200 cows. I bought the cows yesterday, though. And we're just going to gather up the eggs. And that egg there, that really frustrates me, that one. It's really difficult to get. So many times, you just can't quite reach it. Yeah. Right, so there's those two. Right, that's all the eggs on the bus. We have... we've got almost 200 eggs now. Doing quite well. And I'm going to sell this Pottinger Euroboss and the 330T... And I'm going to buy something a bit bigger for when I come to gather up this stuff. Because we have this mahoosive Fendt tractor, I'm thinking my modded ones, where are we? Loading wagons. I've got these. I can't remember what they... Oh, they've been modified so that they can also take wood chips if you want them to. Is that one, the price has been reduced on that one. That one's a smaller one. That's only 40,000. This is a 50,000 litre. And if we go back to standard loading wagons, yeah, 88,000 it's supposed to be. That one's 50,000, that one's 38,000. And then here I've got, so, don't worry about that one. Is this Pottinger here, that's 45,000, and that one's 25. So I'd either go for the jumbo combi line there, or I will just go for the standard game one. I think I'll probably just go for the standard game one, actually. I do quite like using vanilla machines because they are very good. And very often they are perfect for the job. So I think we might just go for this one here, the 88,000 pound one. 50,000 litres, requires 240. We have got a huge tractor that we can pull it with. So I think that'll be just the ticket. Let's go and have a look at our bees a second. They sound fabulous. I really wish that we could get in the back here so that we could actually have a look at our bees, you know, and take the frames out, inspect them, see how they're getting on. I've kept bees. I've kept bees for several years. I don't actually keep bees at the moment, but I have done for many, many years. So I'm quite familiar with how the process works, although I never actually kept them in a big house like that. So here is our wonderful Krone Big M. I'm going to whiz this one up the road and we're going to get started on the next field. Doesn't take very many passes to get through these little fields here. Let me just start this bad boy up. And what's it like when these mowers are up? Dreadful. Yeah, you really can't see very well. So this is definitely more of an out-of-cab kind of experience. Not quite the same as an out-of-body experience, but probably not too far off. This thing is wonderful. I don't understand why he had so many bad reviews on... Well, not necessarily bad reviews, but he did get marked down a bit on ModHoster, where it's from. There is a link in the description down below for this one, don't worry. Definitely included that one for you. I suspect... I think it used to have quite shiny textures. It wasn't textured properly, so you just had this like high-gloss finish on it, and I hate high-gloss finishes. I will not use a mod that has a high-gloss finish unless I'm absolutely forced to, and I have no other choice. It's just a personal thing of mine I don't like. You know, if you're going to go to all the time and effort of making an absolutely fantastic mod, why would you leave it with glossy finishes? It just seems wrong. It just feels wrong on so many levels. So we've got this field here. This one's quite a big field, actually, compared to some of them. And then we will whiz off down to field number 9. I was wondering which ones I should do as hay, so we can just have a look while we're driving down here. We've got this field 80. I'm going to do field 41 as hay, and I'll do field 48 as hay. Probably the two fields would be enough. I don't think we're going to need more than that. So I'm going to assume that 41 and 48 together will be enough hay that we can do. And we may not need to cut field 45 over there. So I will cut all of these fields, and field 45 we'll just leave that one for now. And if we find that we're a little bit short on some stuff to fill up one of the silos, then we could always chuck in a little bit at the end. And I did say that we're going to do some whole crop stuff as well. We will be doing whole crop. We might need to empty one of the silos before we get to the whole crop. We'll worry about that one. Let me just get down to the end, and then we can do the interesting bit around that pylon down there. Right. We're not going to be able to squeeze between the pylon and the hedge, so we'll just swing out round it. I don't want to get too close. I don't know how close you could get to a pylon normally when you're driving around it in a field. As that strange though it may seem, I've worked around hundreds of telegraph poles, but I've never actually worked around a full metal pylon in a field. And considering that I have spent a long time in agriculture, right through my teens and my early 20s, I was in agriculture. I've done all sorts. I've worked for small farms. I've worked on huge, great big estates doing all sorts of harvest work. I've worked for contractors. I've done all sorts. And I've never actually worked in a field that's got a pylon in the middle of it. It seems very bizarre to me. But there you go. Right, we'll do a bit more of this one. Actually, before I do that, let's just admire this thing. Now that I've opened it up, I can sort of drive. Actually, I'm just driving really badly now. Look at that. It's difficult to drive when you can't see what's in front of you, but you do get some good shots. I mean, look at that. That there. If I could drive now so that I'm cutting the right amount and you can see the machine as well, that is brilliant. Look at that thing. It's gorgeous. Right, there we go. That's the end of that row. You sort of get a bit of appreciation now for the difficulty I have when I do my time-lapse series, because very often you'll see when I'm like trying to do baling and stuff like that, I do try to get different angles so that you can see the machinery really well as I'm going. You try baling when you're driving at this angle. It is not the easiest thing I have ever done. And what I normally have to do is I have to focus really intently on exactly where the wheels are going and not look at any other part of the screen, not look at anything else that's going on. And then I sort of watch it back afterwards and then I get to see it. But it is difficult. I mean, when you're doing it like this, it's easy. See, I could do that. I could do that all day. That's very simple. But if I was to do it like this, I would have to concentrate very, very carefully on the outside edge of that mower just to make sure that it was touching the grass. But it would also allow you to see, I've just gone out there. That's terrible. Look at that. But it allows you to get a good sort of view of the machine and see it all working nicely. And I think that's quite important. That's one of the good things about this game, is being able to see all of this stuff. Right, now that I've opened up a couple of rounds, I'm going to do a bit more on this field, and then we can get going into one of the other ones. That's this field nearly finished. Just one more pass after this one, and that'll be done. I'm going to leave one more field, field 9 I think, in rows like this, and then I'm going to leave the next one, or the ones after that, I'm just going to leave them flat on the ground, because there's another mod that I want to show you that is a little bit different to your standard rakes. And I think I already showed you the mod in the shop. It's a different type of rake. And I'd like to use that. I'll use it a bit on the grass, and then I'll use it a bit on, obviously we'll need to use it on the hay anyway. So that one I'll be hiring, but it looks really good. I was quite impressed with it. I'm not quite sure which tedder we're going to be using. There is one I've got that's a mod that could be quite interesting. You're able to angle it and turn it round. That one looks quite good. But the rake in particular I was quite impressed with, and I would like to show you that one. I'm almost done now. So for picking up the silage, once we've done, I'm not going to pick it up with the forage wagon. I'm going to pick it up with the forager and trailer. There we go, let's fold that one up. Right, let's get moving. We still got a lot to do. Can I get through there? Can I go down the track on that side? No, I can't. I've got to go up the top. That's a bit of a shame. Could always cut through the sugar beet field, couldn't I? No, I won't. I'll just go along the road with this one. So yeah, I'll be using the forager, and I'll be using the grass pickup header on it, which I've never actually used before. I've never gone along a swath using that one before, as normally you would only use that one when you got a trailer on behind. But because we've got the follow me mod, I'm going to try and use the two together. I don't know how successful it's going to be. I will confess that it's not my idea. I've seen Dagoin doing it, and Dagoin, as many of you probably know, is absolutely fantastic. He does brilliant videos, and I do regularly watch his videos. I do thoroughly enjoy those. So I will attempt to do what I've seen Dagoin doing with a forager, only I think he used the New Holland one. I'm going to use the standard Krone game one, I think, this time, and I'll worry about using a different one another time. Right, I'm going to get down to field 9 now. Now I'm going on to the bigger road. I need to have my beacons on. Just make sure I do that. Right, there's a car coming there. I want to get in front of him. I don't want to be stuck in traffic. There we go. Oh, I didn't realise you had a beacon on the back as well. That's brilliant. That's a nice little touch. And I haven't forgotten that mower that's in the field. I will pick it up at some point and sell it. Ooh, he drove onto my side of the road. Did you see that? That was definitely him going onto my side then. But anyway, yeah, that mower, I will pick that one up and sell it. I've got a couple other little machines that I need to sell as well. They're just kind of been accumulating. We're going to need to have a bit of a sort through and get rid of some of these soon, I think. Up the speed a little bit now. He does have a nice sort of whine as he's driving along, which is actually a very realistic type of whine. These kind of machines, the drive on them, because they're not geared, you have a lever that you just kind of push forward, and the further forward you push it, the faster it drives. And can't actually remember what that is called offhand, which really is frustrating, because I've used quite a number of machines with that type of drive on it. I can't remember now. It'll come to me. I'll yell it out in the middle of an episode in 3 weeks' time. You watch. Right, I'll start this field. And this is going to be the last one that we leave in rows. Next ones, we will spread them all out. It's not actually very much to this field. Only a little tiny one. I'm guessing that this one isn't going to fill up the sheep. So we'll be dragging some grass down from the top end to sort of top the sheep up as well. That's not going to be an issue. That won't be any problem at all. We have got lots of grass to spare today. I'll just spin round here. This is what I've been doing, is once I've done a couple rounds around the outside, I just literally drive up and down. And I think these things, when you're actually using them in real life, I think they've actually got a GPS tracker on there, which sort of, I don't know if it actually takes control of the steering. I know that some machines and tractors, especially big planting rigs and that, in order to get it absolutely bang on accurate, they have like a GPS tracking device on it that tells you exactly where to go. And some of them, even the steering sort of is taken over by the computer itself. So you just sort of maintain control of the tractor, but you don't do the steering. It does the steering so that it gets it as accurate as possible. I don't know if these huge self-propelled mowers actually do that or not. I wouldn't be surprised to find out that they did. I've got to be honest. Because it's very difficult to be able to drive something like this and accurately keep it full of grass. And you can do it. You could easily keep it 90% full of grass and not leave little stripes like I've done over there while you're driving down. Because you very quickly, while you're driving machines like this, you very quickly adapt to getting your eye in. You know instinctively just how far to keep from the grass there. You don't need a set measuring stick or anything like that. You just kind of figure it out and get your eye in for it. So it is quite possible to do it. But then I wouldn't be surprised to find out that they have a computer system that allows it to really maintain it, you know, keep it full. Because that's what really makes these machines pay, is if you can keep it at 95% or greater of the width full at all times while you're using it, it's obviously going to be paying for itself a lot better than if you only have it like 80% full. Now, let me just pick this one up. Right, I'm going to whiz up to the next field and we'll get started on that one. Just going to see if I can get in here from in cab. Because you really don't... Visibility is really poor with these mowers right up in front of you. It's absolutely awful. Right. That's quite enough of that little exercise. Let's turn off the beacons. Now, this field, or these couple of fields. So we've got this one. We got field 43 just above us. Which one is the biggest one? Job to tell, really. I think field 43 is a fair size. Let's go up and do that one first, actually. There's two of these. Actually, I was thinking to do all the rest of them, as I'm just going to leave them flat on the ground. But I was going to do one of them as hay and two of them as grass. I just wanted to be able to use the rake in the grass. That one's quite big up there, actually. Yeah, I'm not sure. We'll do this one first, I think, and then we can see. Skip up into here. And I like to start going this way round. I'll just leave a piece out by the gate. We've got so much grass that we're doing today that I don't think it's really going to matter all that much. Now, I'm going to not have the swathing option on this time, which is that one. And if you have a look there, do you see that bit was animated? The flaps on the back, that's swathing, and that's turning the swathing off. So now we've turned the swathing off, it'll just leave it all nicely flat on the ground. Let's get going. There we go. So this one, we're going to have to rake it up before we can do anything with it. How big is this field? It goes up that way a little ways. Alright, I'll once again do a couple rounds around the outside, get good and started on this, and then I'll get back to you. We got the castle in there. We do have to go up there. We're going to have to take a day where we can just go and visit the castle one day soon. I think it would be nice to just go up there, have a walk round, a day off from our regular duties, or at least half a day. I think it'd be quite nice. It's something that we're going to do. We will definitely do that before we finish up on this map. We will have a day that we can go and have a little walk around the castle and have a look at it, because we haven't been in there yet. Now, the advantage of cutting everything flat is I don't need to worry about where the rows are. I don't have to worry about the machinery following along behind it, so I can have my lines as untidy as I like. And I don't have to worry about the corners either. I can flip round those and go over them several times if I want to. It does make the life a lot easier. There's a lot less to worry about, a lot less stress. Although now I know that I've got to go back over this and rake it all up. So, yeah, I think there's pros and cons. Just going to keep going round and round this one until he's done. And then I'll drop straight down into the one below. I think we will sort of finish up with that. I will finish all of the mowing today so that we haven't got to sit round and watch this next time. And then I think tomorrow what we'll do is some of it will be ready to rake up, and so that it's ready for going with the silage. But I think what we'll actually do is we'll go over the hay first. We'll get a turner. And we'll go over the hay so that that can sort of be making, and then we can worry about the silage, and then finally we can pick up the hay. As in real life, you would go over that a couple times, and it takes a few days. So what I think we'll do to sort of make this a little bit more realistic, and we do like to try and stick with realism as much as possible, is we will get the hay turned so that can be drying in the sun, and then we can go back and we can pick up the grass, and then finally we can go back over, rake up, and bale up the hay. And I know that something is quite common now, especially now that bales of silage are really easy to make, is if you've got hay fields lined up, they'll actually go round, and especially if you've got trees around the edge of the field, you go and take two passes around the field, or sometimes three passes around the field with your mowers, and row it all up and turn that into silage bales, take those away. And then a week later, you go and mow the grass in the middle. So then you haven't got... Because that's something that's quite difficult, is trying to get the grass to dry underneath the trees where it's in the shade all the time at the same speed as the grass that's out in the middle of the field. So being able to mow and turn into silage a couple rounds around the outside does make the job a lot easier. Now, I did actually consider doing that with this map, take a few rounds around each of the fields and then do hay in the middle, but I've discarded that idea. I think we'll just do... one field for one and another field for another. But that is pretty much all I got time for today, so I will carry on doing this and I will finish up the rest of these fields so they will all be mowed by the time you see me again. Remember our question for this week. Just bring up the thingy here a second. I've got two different mods under feeding technology. I've got the Kuhn SPW25, which is a 25,000 litre self-propelled feeding wagon, which can load itself with silage, obviously. That is a lovely little machine. I've got a much bigger Peecon Bigger Mammoth 64, which is 64,000 litres. But obviously, it's a little bit cheaper because it's trailed, so you've got to tip the silage into it along with the hay and the hay and the straw, unlike this one, which can load some of it itself. So yeah, there's pros and cons for both of them. Which one do you want? Head down below into the comment section. Let me know. Do you want the Kuhn 25 or the Peecon 64? It's your vote. It's your game. Now, just turn round. I've very nearly finished this field now, actually. Only a little tiny bit left. The problem with triangle fields is no matter how you try to approach it, you will always have really short passes across the field, which does get a little bit frustrating sometimes. If you like big long lines across your field, triangle fields are not the way to go. Well, I think that's really all we've got time for today. So if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.